Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, and welcome to Double Reward. Today's surah is Surah Al-Humazah. And in this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes for us several character traits that we have to stay away from. He describes the character trait of backbiting, slander, and hoarding wealth. Is that why we came to this world? Is that why we grew up to become parents and be responsible? To be responsible adults? To backbite our Muslim brothers? Into slander or to hoard wealth? There has to be more to life than these things. But sometimes we fall into these habits, we slip into them. We think that little mistakes are okay. But this surah says, woe unto people who are like this. So we have to try very hard to stay away from this. Let's hear what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويل لكل همزة لمزة الذي جمع مالا وعدده يحسب أن ماله أخلده كلا لينبذن في الحطمة وما أدراك ما الحطمة نار الله الموقدة التي تطلع على الأفئدة إنها عليهم مؤصدة في عمد ممددة.
I seek refuge in Allah from Satan the accursed. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Woe to every slanderer and backbiter who has gathered wealth and counted it. He thinks that his wealth will make him last forever. Nay, verily he will be thrown into the crushing fire. And what will make you know what the crushing fire is? The fire of Allah kindled, which leaps up over the hearts. Verily it shall be closed in on them in pillars stretched forth. You see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises such painful torment for the people who have these character traits, especially if they're disbelievers. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises this to the disbelievers who have these character traits, the believers have to stay away from this and make sure that they clean their character out of these traits. It's hard and it takes a long time, but it's very much worthwhile. Let's practice this surah together here, inshallah. Are you guys ready?
Inshallah.
Okay. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
Waylul likulli humazatil lumazah.
وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ
الَّذِي جَمَعَ مَالًا وَعَدَّدَهُ
الَّذِي جَمَعَ مَالًا وَعَدَّدَهُ
يَحْسَبُ أَنَّ مَالَهُ أَخْلَدَهُ
يَحْسَبُ أَنَّ مَالَهُ أَخْلَدَهُ
كَلَّا لَيُنْبَذَنَّ فِي الْحُطَمَةِ
لَيُنْبَذَنَّ فِي الْحُطَمَةِ
وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْحُطَمَةِ
وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْحُطَمَةِ
نَارُ اللَّهِ الْمُوقَدَةِ
نَارُ اللَّهِ الْمُوقَدَةِ
الَّتِي تَطَّلِعُ عَلَى الْأَفْئِدَةِ
التي تطلع على الأفئدة
إنها عليهم مؤصدة
إنها عليهم مؤصدة
في عمد ممددة
في عمد ممددة
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
ويل لكل همزة لمزة
ويل لكل همزة لمزة
الذي جمع مالا وعدده
الذي جمع مالا وعدده
يحسب أن ماله أخلده
يحسب أن ماله أخلده
كلا
كلا
لينبذن في الحطمة
لينبذن في الحطمة
وما أدراك ما الحطمة
وما أدراك ما الحطمة
نار الله الموقدة
نار الله الموقدة
التي تطلع على الأفئدة
التي تطلع على الأفئدة
إنها عليهم مؤصدة
إنها عليهم مؤصدة
في عمد ممددة
في عمد ممددة
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
ويل لكل همزة لمزة
ويل لكل همزة لمزة
الذي جمع مالا وعدده
الذي جمع مالا وعدده
يحسب أن ماله أخلده
يحسب أن ماله أخلده
كلا
كلا
لينبذن في الحطمة
لينبذن في الحطمة
وما أدراك ما الحطمة
وما أدراك ما الحطمة
نار الله الموقدة
نار الله الموقدة
التي تطلع على الأفئدة
التي تطلع على الأفئدة
إنها عليهم مؤصدة
إنها عليهم مؤصدة
في عمد ممددة
في عمد ممددة
الحمد لله رب العالمين ما شاء الله very good I love this surah I really do I feel it has a very special sound to it and it makes me feel good when I read it Do any of you feel that way when you read that surah?
Yes we do
MashaAllah. Okay, let's practice that surah. Fairuz, why don't you start out this time for us?
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wailun likulli humazatin lumazah. Alladhi jama'a malan wa 'addada. Yahsabu anna malahu akhlada. كلا لينبذن في الحطمة وما أدراك ما الحطمة نار الله الموقدة التي تطلع على الأفئدة
Can you hold up there? Can you articulate those two عينs right after each other? I know it's kind of hard, but I know you can do it.
التي تطلع على الأفئدة
التي تطلع على الأفئدة
التي تطلع على الأفئدة إنها عليهم مؤصدة في عمد ممددة
ما شاء الله أحسنت very good ما شاء الله okay Usama, let's practice two verses together, inshallah.
Inshallah. Okay.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
Waylul likulli humazatil lumazah.
Waylul likulli humazatil lumazah.
Alladhi jama'a malan wa 'addadah.
Alladhi jama'a malan wa 'addadah.
Okay. Very good. Ahmed, you want to cover those same two verses again?
Sure.
Okay, let's say them together. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
ويل لكل همزة لمزة.
ويل ويل لكل همزة لمزة.
Very good. ويل لكل همزة لمزة.
ويل لكل همزة لمزة.
الذي جمع مالا وعدده.
الذي جمع مالا وعدده.
Okay, very good job. MashaAllah. Now, what you should try to do is tonight you should try to review the surah. Okay, and try to practice it.
Okay. How?
Well, what you can do is, oh, that's a good question. There are lots of ways. There are lots of things you can do. The first thing is you can get a tape. Well, the best thing for you to do is to have a teacher.
Okay.
Okay. And that's for our viewers at home. If you can find a teacher to help and sit down with you and come to your home, you know, once every day or 3 times a week, etc., you can learn with your teacher. Your teacher will direct you. But what you can do is you can get a tape. Okay, you can get, like, for example, a tape of Sheikh al-Minshawi or Sheikh al-Ajami, or you can get a tape of Sheikh Mustafa Ismail. Mm-hmm. You can get one of these very renowned qaris or reciters, and you can read after them.
Okay.
Usam, have you tried something like that?
Yes.
Okay. How have you found that it helps you?
It helps me with my recitation, and it helps me to memorize the surah.
Okay. Do you feel like you feel like that when you're reading with him, he helps you to pronounce the letters?
Yes.
Okay, that's a very important thing. Makharij al-huruf, or the articulation, it's very important to get that from an expert. And listening to it and saying it, listening to it and saying it, that's the formula for success. Okay.
Okay.
Ferdows, can you read that the surah for us?
Inshallah.
Okay, go ahead.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Waylun likulli humazatin lumazah. Alladhi jama'a malan wa'addada. Yahsabu anna malahu akhlada. كلا لينبذن في الحطمة.
Okay, hold up there. That sound, حطمة, it's a ta sound.
حطمة.
Yeah, I didn't want to break off your recitation because it sounded so beautiful. Okay, one more time. لينبذن في الحطمة.
لينبذن في الحطمة.
Okay.
وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْحُطَمَةِ
وَمَا أَدَ
وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْحُطَمَةِ
Now repeat after me. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ
وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْحُطَمَةِ
Okay, there isn't a pause at the qalqala. Okay. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ
وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ
أَدَ
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 أد.
Okay, we're going to have to work on that.
Okay.
Okay. وما أدراك ما الحطمة.
وما أدراك ما الحطمة.
Okay, keep going. We're going to have
نار
to
نار الله الموقدة التي تطلع على الأفئدة إنها عليهم مؤصدة في عمد ممددة.
Okay, that was very good. We're going to have to work on that قلقلة, inshallah. We're going to come up to that, inshallah. And we're out of time, and we're going to stop for a break, but we'll be back, inshallah, after the break is over. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه ورتل القرآن ترتيلا. Learning how to recite the Quran properly. Learning the meaning of what we recite. Concluding the ahkam from the verses which we recite. Trying to implement what we learn in our daily life. We'll listen to the participants and the guests. We'll take your phone calls. We're going to recite live. We'll listen to your recitation. And we'll correct it according to the rules and regulations which we'll state in each episode. Now, your dream will come true.
إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ.
Assalamu alaikum, welcome back. Inshallah, today we're going to be looking at a new rule or new hukm. That rule is idgham. Now, in Arabic and in the Quran, the closer the letters get to each other, the more they like each other and the more they mix up together. The farther they are, the more articulated, the more they don't mix up and the more articulated each letter gets. Let's look at some examples that are going to illustrate that. The first example is min waq. Okay, this noon is pronounced at the front of your mouth, n. And also, the meme is pronounced at the front of your mouth. Because these are articulated in places that are close to each other, they mix together. And in today's hukm, what happens is the noon and the meme, they mix together and they become one stressed letter. Inshallah, an example will clear all of that up. So in our hukm today, we're going to be looking for a noon as sakina, and one of six letters. The first one is ya, the second one is ra, or meem, lam, waw, or noon. So whenever you have a noon sakina in any one of these letters, anywhere in the mushaf, you know that there is idgham. So you're probably thinking to yourself, oh, those are six letters. How am I going to remember them? Inshallah, we're going to work on a way, and it'll be very, very easy. There's a word that summarizes all of those letters. If you remember that word, you'll always be able to remember what those letters are. You'll just put that word in your pocket. Whenever you come across one of those letters, you'll pull that word out, and you'll know whether idgham applies or not. That word is pronounced yarmalun. Say that after me. Yarmalun.
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 Ahmed, can you remember that word? Say it for me.
Yarmalun.
Good. Firdaus?
Yarmalun.
Okay, excellent. Very good. Now, what's the first letter in Yarmalun?
Ya.
Very good. Ahmed, what's the second letter in Yarmalun?
Ra.
Very good. Yarmalun. Usama, the next letter?
Meem.
Good. And Firdaus? Yarmalun.
The lam.
Good. And the remaining one, the next two? Ahmed?
Yarmalun. Is noon?
No.
Wow.
Wow, very
Sorry.
Good.
Sorry.
And the last one?
Noon.
Noon. So, now let's look at some examples. The first example is لِمَن يَخْشَى. But remember what we said about learning أحكام التجويد? The first thing we're going to do is we're going to take the rule, we're not going to apply the rule. We're going to look at the two words bear, as if they would be pronounced outside of the Qur'an. Outside of the Qur'an, we would say, لِمَن يَخْشَى. But in the Qur'an, we say, لِمَن يَخْشَى. Repeat after me. لِمَن يَخْشَى.
لِمَن يَخْشَى.
لِمَن يَخْشَى.
لِمَن يَخْشَى.
Do you hear a difference?
Yes.
Yes.
That is idgham. So what happened? Well, what happened was, the noon sakina in limen and the ya became one stressed letter. Let's look at another example. The next one is فَلَن نَزِيدَكُمْ. Now, outside of the Qur'an, without the hukm, this is pronounced فَلَن نَزِيدَكُمْ. But in the Qur'an, it's pronounced فَلَن نَزِيدَكُمْ. Let me see how sharp your ears are. Ahmed, can you tell me the difference between those two pronunciations? فَلَن نَزِيدَكُمْ and فَلَن نَزِيدَكُمْ.
There's a humming on the second one. It's longer.
Excellent, so. Excellent. It's longer. Yeah. And that's a very important point to keep in mind. In idgham, there's a lengthening of your voice, and I think you can hear it. There's a slight humming sound. And that's what we're looking at here. This humming sound is called a ghunna. Repeat after me. Ghunna.
Ghunna.
غُنَّة
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 غُنَّة.
We're going to look at some examples later on without a غُنَّة. But for now, all you need to know is that the غُنَّة lengthens the sound a little bit. Let's look at another example. The next example is, without إدغام, it's pronounced مِن مَا. Repeat after me. مِن مَا.
مِن مَا.
مِن مَا.
مِن مَا.
Now, with إدغام, it's pronounced مِمَّا. Repeat after me. مِمَّا.
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 Okay, now let me ask you a question to make sure that you're paying that you guys are alert and on top of it. What is the letter after min? Usama?
Meme.
Meme. Now, what letter, meme, what does that mean? What rule applies here?
I might need a little help.
Okay, well, remember what we said? We're working today on idgham.
Idgham, yes.
Okay, so how do you know that idgham applies?
Because meme is in the word yarmalun.
Very good, excellent. So you know the rule, but you're just not remembering the name.
Yes.
Okay, inshallah, you'll be able to remember the name, the letter, how to find it on the page, and how to pronounce it,
inshallah.
Inshallah. But it'll take some time. Okay, now let's look at another example. Now, before I pronounce this, I want to ask you guys, what is the sound, what is the letter that's coming after the noon? Firdaus, what is it?
Waw.
Waw. Okay, now what does that waw mean?
Waw, that means if after noon sakina,
uh-huh.
if you have either six words, I mean yarmalun, so waw is one of the words, so we have to, I mean,
apply
the idgham inside it.
Okay, so basically, you see that the you got that waw there, and then you have that word in your head, which is yarmalun, and so you know that idgham applies here based on that word, because that word summarizes all the letters of idgham.
Yeah.
Okay, that's very good. Now, of course, you may not go through that process in your head in those steps, but that's basically intuitively what you do. But if it's hard for you, you could go through that specifically, you know, in that specific order, until it becomes second nature to you. Okay?
Okay.
All right. Now let's move on to another example. This next example is pronounced outside of the Qur'an, لَن يَقْدِر. But in the Qur'an, and with إدغام, we say, لَن يَقْدِر. Okay? So repeat after me. لَن يَقْدِر.
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 Okay. Usama, can you tell me what the letter is after the noon? لَن يَقْدِر.
Yeah.
Yeah, very good. Excellent. Now, did you remember that? Now, notice that there was a humming sound, or there was a longing of your voice.
Yeah.
That's with غنة. What we're going to look at now are examples without غنة. The same thing is going to happen to the noon. The noon is going to disappear with the next, and both letters are going to become one letter, and we're going to stress the sound. Okay. But there isn't going to be a غنة. Okay?
Okay.
So let's look at an example of that. Outside of the Quran and without idgham, this is pronounced an len. Okay? With idgham, it's pronounced al len. Okay? So repeat after me. An len.
An len.
Al len.
Al len.
Al len.
Al len.
Al len.
Al len.
So where did the noon go? The noon, because there's idgham here, we don't pronounce the noon, we go straight into the lam. But now the question we're asking is, so where's the ghunna? Notice that I didn't say al-lan. I didn't draw my voice out. I said al-lan. Whereas with the ghunna, I did draw my voice out. I said لِمَنْ يَخْشَى. Okay? So let's take two examples and try to hear the difference. Okay? Repeat after me. لِمَنْ يَخْشَى
لِمَنْ يَخْشَى
أَلَّنْ
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 Okay, very good. Now, the thing to know is that there are only two letters that don't have a ghunnah, and they are lam and they are ra. So let's look at our examples and try to find the noon, the lam, and try to see what we've got here, what hukm we have. The next example is pronounced min rabbik, without idgham. Fairuz, can you tell me what rule applies here, and how do you know?
Idgham applies here.
Okay.
But without the ghunnah.
Okay, how did you know?
Because there's a ra after the noon sakin.
Exactly.
Yeah.
All right, very good. Now let's look at another example. Min Rasul. This is pronounced with idgham. Mir Rasul. Say it with me. Mir Rasul.
Mir Rasul.
Mir Rasul.
Mir Rasul.
Mir Rasul.
Mir Rasul.
Okay, very good. Ahmed, mm-hmm. Do you feel like you see there? You see that that there's no ghunnah here.
Mm-hmm.
You feel like you see that we went straight into the lam without pronouncing the noon.
Because there's a ra.
Because there's a ra.
Ra, ra.
Okay, very good. Yeah, that's right. You've got the ra and the lam. Whenever you've got any one of these two letters, there's no ghunnah.
Okay,
excellent. Let's move on to our next example. This is pronounced mir rabbihim. Repeat after me. Mir rabbihim.
Mir rabbihim.
Mir rabbihim.
Mir rabbihim.
Mir rabbihim.
Mir rabbihim.
Very good. And let's move on to another example. Mil ladunhu. Repeat after me. Mil ladunhu.
Mil ladunhu.
Mil ladunhu.
Mil ladunhu.
Okay, very good. So now let's ask some questions. Inshallah, I think you guys are ready. The question I want to ask is, Fairuz, could you tell me what idgham is?
Yeah, idgham is when one of the letters of Yarmalun appears after Nun Sakina, you have to sort of delete the Nun and lengthen your voice a bit on the Ya,
okay.
For example.
Yeah, that's very good. But now remember, there's going to be two cases with idgham. There's idgham with ghunnah and idgham without ghunnah. So in the case of with ghunnah, you're going to have to lengthen your voice.
Yeah.
Okay? Like, لِمَنْ يَخْشَى. But without ghunnah, if you have a lam or a ra, you're not going to lengthen your voice.
That's right.
Like, أَلَّمْ. Okay, very good. Usama, can you tell us how to find idgham?
You find idgham when you have any of the letters in the word yanlum, yarmalun.
Yeah, very good, excellent.
And they are after inun.
Okay. Very good, excellent. Okay, so basically that's our hukm. This hukm is present in so many places in the Quran, and as a student of the Quran, you're going to have a very, very long career with idgham. So I hope you learn that rule well, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum. And inshallah, we'll see you next time.